Hello, I'm Dr. Shraddha Jethani. I'm practicing as a dermatologist, venerologist and nephrologist in Raipur, Chhattisgarh. I will tell you the most common hair problems that we face in our clinic. First, I'll tell you there are 1 lakh to 1 lakh 50,000 hair in our scalp and about 50 to 100 hair loss per day is normal. If there is hair thinning or scalp is visible, or there is more than 100 hair loss per day, then it's a problem. We have to rule out the causes of hair loss. The most common causes of hair loss are nutritional deficiencies. We have to rule out the iron, protein, minerals deficiency. For that, we have to do various investigations. Then we have to ask the history of various medicines that most commonly cause hair loss. Certain antidepressants, birth control pills, chemotherapy, radiation therapy are also responsible for hair loss. We also have to rule out the hormonal causes. During pregnancy and lactation, most of the females complain of hair loss. Then the overactive and underactive thyroid is also responsible for hair loss. Stress and autoimmune causes are also responsible for hair loss. Next most common problem that we look in our clinic is graying of hair. Graying of hair is basically genetically determined. Most of the children, they have the history of their parents of early graying of hair. Facia areata is another most commonly problem that we look in our clinic. In that, there is patchy loss of the hair. It can be seen over scalp or any other hairy part of our body. The problem is a male and the female pattern baldness. Various medical treatment as well as the procedures are available for the male and the female pattern hair loss. Topical minoxidil is used, oral finasteride is used, and the procedures like platelet-rich plasma therapy, microneedling is done for male and the female pattern baldness. I'll tell you about PRP and microneedling procedures. In PRP, we collect the blood of the patient, centrifuge it, and then the platelet-rich plasma is injected over the hair follicles. In microneedling, we use a derma roller. It releases certain growth factors which help in the growth of the hair follicles. In the full-blown bald patches of the male and the female pattern alopecia, we have to go for hair transplantation. Now I will tell you certain hair care tips that we should follow routinely. First is the healthy diet. Our diet should include proteins, vitamins, all the essential minerals. Protein-rich diet includes dairy products, meat. Those who are non-vegetarian can eat the meat, chicken, beans, peanuts, and also green leafy vegetables are very essential for a healthy and a balanced diet. Biotin, vitamin D, omega-3 fatty acids are very essential for our hair growth. Water is very essential for healthy hair, so you should drink lot of fluid, lot of water every day in order to make your hair healthy. You should use proper shampoo and conditioners. Always prefer the silicone based products because silicone will coat your hair and it will protect from the stress. Those who have dry and frizzy hair should always use proper conditioners. Oiling twice a week nourishes your hair root, so you should do proper oiling. Always air dry your hair. Avoid blow dryer, straightening procedures because this will cause damage in your cuticle, hair cuticle, and your hair will become brittle and frizzy. Protect your hair from sun damage, wind pollution. Always use a bathing cap while in swimming pools. Myth is to shampoo hair every day, but over shampooing will cause your hair dry and hair becomes frizzy and brittle. her all the healthcare tips. If you like my video, then kindly like, share and subscribe my video.